We're joined today by Garrett Toy with Ag Trader Talk. And Garrett, as we look at this latest USDA report, the WASDE report just came out. What are your takeaways here? What are the big keys? They did make some moves that we weren't really expecting here.
No, absolutely. You know, and I kind of warned, we have obviously well aware of the slow planting pace that we've had this spring in the U.S. as far as getting the row crops in. But, you know, historically, the USDA doesn't make much yield adjustments in this report from the February Ag Outlook Forum, which is essentially their first look at the new crop S&Ds. But the fact that we are so far behind on planting, they did decide to make an adjustment. They said they deviated from their weather trend adjusted yield, trend line yield, which was 181 in February. They dropped it down to 177, which is a 4 bushel an acre cut, obviously. But this is very rare that they do it. It's been, you know, in fact, I think it's been about 7 years or 8 years since they've made, 2013 was the last time that they've made an adjustment in May. They have done cuts in June before, like in 2019. You know, and that was kind of the mindset, is like, well, if we didn't cut it in 2019, they're not going to cut it today, right? But they did. But the difference with 2019 is that they came back and raised yields in July, and it kind of left the market wondering what exactly is going on here. And I don't think they really understood what the crop size was in 2019 until that March 1st stocks report of 2020. So I think they're being a little bit more proactive in this report, and it's, I think the 177 number has been a more conservative type number, but it definitely tightens things up. You know, the market reactions that pushed East corn back to 750 levels, and it's going to mean essentially that, you know, the USDA admits that this market, this crop, is going to be behind the eight ball for the rest of the year, and weather is going to be very important.
Yeah, and we talk to farmers like yourself out there trying to get the crop in the ground right now. And I think, you know, nobody's really arguing with USDA's moves here. It's just, it's different. It was just not something we expected. Hey, as we look at the wheat number, those came in and obviously making some adjustments to production there. That's got that market pretty wound up today as well.
Right. The main focus in this report was going to be the feed grains, and that was largely on the heels of the Ukraine-Russian situation. And I look here, and they cut Ukraine corn production. It's 19.5 million metric ton versus 42 last year. Exports of 9 against 23. Their wheat numbers are 21. Their wheat numbers are going to be down about 12 million metric ton from last year, and 9 million metric ton less exports. So that's a starting point. Obviously, the Ukraine situation is still ongoing. But I think the market was looking for an aggressive USDA as far as what production cuts are occurring. Now, the interesting thing, you know, flipping back to corn here real quick, is that USDA is forecasting record Argentine corn exports, record Brazil corn exports. And in reality, U.S. corn exports are still going to be down year over year, even though we pick up a little bit slightly larger share of the world trade number. The USDA is basically telling us that they think that Brazil, as long as they have weather, Brazil and Ukraine should pick up a lot of the slack that Ukraine had lost.
Yeah, as we look at this kind of the drought and dryness situation in the Southern Plains, we saw them make some adjustments to cotton here. That market's rallying a little bit. As you start to extrapolate this and look forward, Garrett, what are the big things that you'll watch here in the next few weeks as we get toward that June report?
Well, and that's one thing as well, is the USDA, you know, noted the dryness in the Southern Plains, because the hard red wheat number today was a big miss by the trade. The hard red wheat crop came in at 590. The average trade guess was 685 million bushel, so we missed it by 95 million bushel. The soft red wheat crop was right in line at 354. It was about 5 million bushel less than the number. But this should still keep, even though the majority of the money flow is still because of the volume proximity that likes to trade the Chicago contract. But we should see, especially with the planting delays on the Northern Plains, we should see the protein wheat start to gain on Chicago, Kansas City gain on Chicago, Minneapolis gain on Chicago, because of the, as well as there's weather in Canada as well, that I see that they're potentially abandoning some corn and bean acres up there. So the situation in the Northern Plains, I think you're going to see wheat classes gain. The market's going to trade weather forecasts on the row crops on a day-by-day basis. But we should see a decent, given the progress that we've seen this week. Next week's numbers should be closer, to true, or should see a decent jump in planting progress, I should say. Typically, when we look at these trend-adjusted yield models that the USDA puts out, we want U.S. corn planting to be 50% completed as May 10th, and we are 28% behind that number. So, if we can get close to that 50% number within a week, people will be a little bit more satisfied with their models.
Yeah, absolutely. Garrett, appreciate you being here. Thank you so much for walking us through today's report. Garrett Toy, Ag Trader Talk. Thanks for watching us on Ag Web, and make sure you tune in on agday.com.